I love you.
So I'm going to go right into it. This is my last gel set on my natural nails, inspired by Britney Spears. I'm going to file the top. I was going to file all the gel off, but these are my natural nails, so I decided I was going to end up soaking it anyways, just so I don't ruin my natural nails. So after the polish is all off, I usually buff, file, wash my hands, and I put the base coat on. And I'm going to start on my right hand because I like using my non-dominant hand first because it's harder. And this thumb is going to be based off of the tongue of the shoe. So I'm going to be painting it black. And then while that's drying, since I'm using regular polish, I'm going to move on to the next nail. I'm starting with a yellow. I wasn't really sure what I was going to do, but I started with a yellow. And then my next nail, I put a green French tip just so it's different from the other ones, you know, adds a little something. This is going to be based off of the bottom of the shoe, the sole, I guess. The next finger is purple because I'm going to base that off of the tongue of the shoe. So as you can see, it's purple and then it has the orange laces on top. And then my pinky is just going to be this golden color with little sparkles. But you won't really see that after anyways. So I went back over the yellow with the orange color because I wanted to actually do that little strip of orange with the reflective piece since I have a silver nail polish. And after that, I went ahead back to the first nail and I started doing the little hatch marks with the orange. And I don't have any nail brushes, so I've been using paint brushes. It's not very precise, but I guess I got the job done. And again, this is my non-dominant hand, so it's extra interesting. So yeah, I was admiring how it turned out. I was like, wow, it looks pretty good. So next I'm doing the little silver stripe on the orange. So I've been using eyeliner for any thin black details that I need. So I'm using that to trace over the French tip just to add a little more to it. And it kind of cleans up the messiness, you know, since I freehanded it. Now I'm doing the orange laces using the same brush. I only use this brush because it's all I have. But yeah, I don't really care about it being too perfect because they're laces. And I feel like hand-painted nail designs don't need to be perfect. I think there's something nice about, like, the mistakes, you know? So for this nail, I decided I was actually going to do the waffle print again. But I'm doing the inverse color, so instead of yellow stripes, I'm doing black stripes on the yellow or gold. Yeah, with the liner as well. And then I'm going back to the thumb and I'm drawing the Le Fleur. I think that's what the flower is called, but the Golf Le Fleur flower, you know, Tyler's flower. So I realized I cut up a lot of the footage, so I don't have enough time to talk about things I would like to talk about because I talk a lot. But okay, no, I'm running out of time, never mind. So I'm moving back to the other nail while that dries, and I'm adding this little squiggly part because on the sole there's like the thing that holds the laces and it's squiggly, and it's this nice teal color, the same color as what I use on the thumb. Now I'm putting the little black circle of the flower. I wanted to mention, oh my gosh, I love Tyler the Creator. I got these shoes last Flogna. I was in line for a really long time debating on which colorway I should get. Okay, yeah, I'm adding to that one nail, like, little details because, yeah, I don't know. Oh my gosh, this is too fast. Now I'm taking the liner again and I decided I'm gonna trace over everything on that nail just to make it pop so the colors stand out. Side note, doesn't this colorway remind you of Lazy Town, that old show with the girl with the pink hair? On the second day, my friends and I, right away, we went in line for 2 hours to get some shoes, and I ended up getting these Giannos. Okay, now moving on to the next hand, I'm doing the same thing on the thumb. I'm gonna base it off of the other shoe where it's the Converse logo. It was so hot, you guys, and I was wearing overalls and I was sweating. Okay, this nail, I'm doing the teal color. I didn't know what I was gonna do, but I knew I wanted to have that color on one of the nails. I skipped over the middle finger and I put yellow. I was gonna do the same thing I did on the pinky, but I decided not to use that other gold color. I didn't really like it. So I'm putting this metallic squiggly line just to copy that little squiggly line on the shoe. Pretty self-explanatory. The pinky, I really did not know what I was gonna do, but I wanted to incorporate that green color again from the bottom of the shoe. And then I'm going back on the thumb and I'm adding the orange. And since this is my dominant hand, I was trying to make it much nicer, but it ended up looking the same, so it's whatever. Back to what I was saying. Yeah, it was super hot, but we ended up getting the shoes. It barely fit in the locker because, like, 4 of us shared a locker. No, 3 of us. But yeah, we had other stuff. It was fun. I love Flagna. Like, I could talk about it all day. I could talk about Tyler, the Creator, all day. I'm obsessed. No, I wouldn't say obsessed. Just, like, he's very important to my life. Ew, that's so corny. Okay, anyways, so my pointer finger, I decided I'm gonna do that thing that I just showed. That little green thing with the squares. It's just a little detail, you know? So I was gonna incorporate it. This ended up being like one of my favorite fingers. Oh my gosh, what? Yeah. It ended up being really nice. So now I'm tracing the squiggly line. And I ended up wanting to make it thicker, but I just didn't. I think I didn't want to mess it up, so I ended up just doing that. This clip is so long compared to all the other clips. Okay, so this nail, I'm doing the waffle thing, and for some reason I could not do a straight line. Like, it was so wobbly, but I guess it looked fine. I have a very low standards when it comes to my nails. No, not low standards. Like, it all looks good when it comes together, but I'm not really a perfectionist, if you know what I mean. Like, if it looks good from far away, that's enough for me. So, the pinky, I didn't know what I was doing with it. I started putting black because I wanted to copy the bottom of the shoe, but I realized that that was not gonna work or look good. So I quickly took the purple to cover it, and I ended up just following the little wave layer, the patterns. What? The patterns of the layers, like the black, green, black, brown, purple, or whatever. You know what I mean. This pinky is probably my least favorite out of all of them. Very simple, random, kind of ugly, but it all it like ties in together, right? Yeah. So I'm going back to the thumb and I'm doing the Converse logo. And you can't see because I kept getting out of frame. Like, if you saw my setup, you'd laugh. So I was doing the logo, and then I look at it, and I'm like, what the fuck? I messed up. So I cover it with black, and then I have to wait for it to dry. And while I waited for it to dry, I put the top coat on my other hand. So, yeah, I fixed it. What? Where am I? I'm adding details to my other finger. Yes. Yeah. Okay. So, I put the teal color the right way because I'm learning from my mistakes. And it's supposed to be the less than sign. So, there you go. Ended up looking pretty good. And this is me looking at my nails and I'm like, wow. And all I had to do was put the top coat. And now the last part was putting some cuticle oil, which is my favorite. Because for some reason, like, it just makes it look all done. Because those nail salon photos or nail photos, they all have, like, oiled cuticles and it looks really good. So yeah, I put a gel top coat. That's why it's shiny and nice. And that's how I grow out my natural nails. And this is the finished look. Thank you so much for watching. Shout out Converse Giannos. This shit is not sponsored. I have a lot of other nail ideas, so hopefully I'll have more videos coming soon, and I'll see you next time. Bye.